Hey folks, welcome back. In the part 1, we had discussed about the demo application. We also wrote the test scenarios for sign up as well as login page. So this part 2 is about the story 2. So before we begin, if you have not watched that part 1, I will leave the link in the description. Please go and check out. So let us see what the story 2 talks about. At the top of the home page, carousel images should be displayed. On the home page, all the products should be listed in the card format. The product should have all the relevant details about the product. And on click of different categories such as phones, laptop and monitors, users should be able to see the relevant product list and details. If we see the story 2, it majorly talks about only the UI part. So when it comes to UI, we will not get much negative test cases. So most of the time when we verify the UI, it will be a straightforward scenario. So let us understand it on the application level. So as per the acceptance criteria, the carousel images should be displayed on the top of the screen. So homepage. So this is the moving image, and suppose if I click on here, this gets me to the next image present in the list. So, and the next thing what we spoke was about this, each of the products should be displayed in the card format. So this particular overlay, whatever you are seeing, is a card. Okay. So, and also the product should be displayed with the minimum like relevant details about the product. Suppose this is the product name and then what is the price of it and a description about it. So this is what we spoke about. And another acceptance criteria was talking about the categories, right? Another point in the acceptance criteria. So we have different options like phones, laptops and monitors. On click of phones, what should happen? The relevant details of the phone, only the images or the products related to phone, only those must display. Okay. And if I click on laptop, only the laptop, the laptop product should display. Okay. In the same way, it should work with monitors. If I click on monitor, whichever monitors are present, those should display. So this is what the acceptance criteria talks about. So for this, let us write the test scenario. I have already prepared it, so let's see that. So here is the test scenario. Verify scrolling images are displayed. So in the acceptance criteria, we were talking about the carousel images. So that is what we are verifying. The first scenario we are talking is that the scrolling images are displaying or not is the first scenario. So in here, we will come across two of the test cases. So if we see on the UI, right? So what we will get is on here, when we load the page, it starts moving, right? And also another scenario is when we click on this arrow. So here there are two scenarios, two test cases that we can cover. So that is why we have written two test cases. Verify scrolling images are displayed on the home page. You know, once you land on the page, you will see that carousel images which are moving by itself. You need not to even click on the arrow. And another test case is when if I click on the arrow, what should happen? That is another test case. So simply to write the steps, once I launch the application on the home screen itself, it should display by itself is the first test case. Okay. And what is the expected behavior? Expected behavior is so simple that user should be able to see the scrolling images. Okay. It is very simple and straightforward. And each of the test case will have an acceptance criteria. It might have different steps, but the expected behavior is only one that we have to write. And one another validation what we can do is on UI, you will not get much test cases, because it will be of straightforward scenarios, right? So almost if you see this particular test scenario, right, verify that each of the product is shown in the card format. It is straightforward. This scenario itself, we can write it as a test case. This will not have, you know, multiple test case. In case of validation, suppose say you have a functionality, that is where it comes into picture. You will get a lot of negative test cases in case of functionality validation, and if you are verifying something like text box, so that is where you will get lots and lots of negative scenarios, as well as positive scenarios is one, like happy path, and you will also have to test the negative scenarios. But in UI, usually we will not get much negative test case. Okay, so this is as straightforward. Verify that the product shown in the card format. So if we see this here, we have each of the product displayed in the card format, and then this is what we are verifying in here, which is a very straightforward scenario. And then the next scenario, whatever we have written, is verify that the product details is displayed on the card. So product details, when we see here, these are the product details. So that is what we are verifying, right? So that is where this is the only one scenario we can think of. Otherwise, you can either split it. You can split it as in verify that price is displaying, and the product description is displaying or not, and whether that product description matches certain the prototype that they have provided. So certain other cases comes into picture. While you write, it is up to the testers basically. And the next scenario is verify that different categories such as phones, laptops and monitors displays the relevant products. So in here we see that there are three different categories: phones, laptops and monitors. On click of this, the details related to the phones should be displayed. So that is what we are writing here. So it is very easy that a test scenario might have lot of test case, and one test case might have lot of test steps, but it should have only one acceptance criteria. So this is in that formulation. Okay, and here also we can verify different formats, like phone we can phone category, as well as laptops, as well as monitors, three different test cases that we can cover as part of this. So, and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.